I've ever felt a pain. This hurtful has cut this deep in my heart. I'm not mad at you though. I've seen you stomp out. Take out of the waiting area there. And I heard you say, I don't want to do this. Here come 500 pounds of worthless shit behind you. In your ear, like always. Convincing you of what you need to do when you don't want to do it. And when you came back that Christmas, and you were on the phone with her, and we just got there. Our home was our home. He said, I feel comfortable with him. I feel safe with him. I don't want him to keep you from me. If I said anything like that, she was already starting to get in your head. And then she gets on the phone with this dumbass queer motherfucking psychic or some shit, or fucking YouTube. The fuck every shit, stupid shit was talking about me on there. No, bitch, I'm the only motherfucker that ever gave a fuck about your daughter, cause you don't, worthless fucking piece of trash. And okay, I kind of realized today that she probably had something to do with Brittany's death too. No, Casey gave her the outpack. I'm not saying she did, and she did. Think your mom knew about it. Don't you think about something for me, please? He said her and your sister got big ass fight. She had hated your mom after that, never had nothing else to say to her. She never told you what that fight was about, did she? But you asked, but she never told you. That night she was at your house all fucked up. Was she really, really fucked up, Kate? I mean, real bad fucked up more than usual. Think about it for me. Cause I bet. I'll tell you, this was eating her alive. What I already know, and I've already told you, and she's glad I did. She found out that your mom let that man do that to you. And I bet she started beating on his ass because she looked a little rough out of the lake at some point. And, you know, disgust, just hates the man, like, much like I hate. I see my blood just boils. I want to just snatch him up and snap his fucking neck. That's not the point. I bet she was going to tell you. I bet she told her mom she was going to tell you. Almost positive. She made you go in that courtroom, okay? Because I only glanced at you for a second. It hurt so bad. But you know that's all I need. And look at me when I seen the tears starting to well up in your eyes, because I know you. That wasn't what you wanted to do. And I ain't seen no happiness in you anywhere. You wanted to do. You know why she made you go in there? Because she wants you, she knows to tear you apart or tear at you. Because she knows you love me. She wants to destroy you, tear you down, so she can live off your death. She she took her kids or made that fake ass bogus call. For a fact she did. She's a piece of fucking trash like that. And guess what? My Facebook, that old Sam Taylor, what did she say? Section 8 gutter slut and her kids. Guess who that was, people? That was her mom. So I commented, and this is Kate's mom. And all of a sudden, Sam Taylor disappeared. I never got a single another comment from Sam Taylor. Isn't that interesting? She's happy you fuck all these guys and pimp you out, trying to get you to forget about me, but you never forget about me like I don't forget about you. You told me you tore me apart. Whenever I was with someone, I was always thinking about you. What would he say? What would he think? Now that your mom put that shit in your head. I know what that bitch is doing now. Those kids were telling us no, where she belongs. This isn't who she belongs. But every time, you know, because my friend talked to you a couple days before, and she still loves you. I can tell. She got quiet. She misses you. Next time he called, you were with somebody at some place. He said you act totally different. That's because your piece of shit fucking mom was there. How'd you call the cops? I know what that bitch did now. Because a week later, I dropped her off over by your house. They spent like 3 hours there talking to you. Yeah, and you miss me. And you do love me. And Brian told me he said the same thing. He said, you know who you should be with. That man will stop betraying for you. I know he will. I do love him. And then you told him how good the kids were, or how much the kids loved me, how good I was to you. I had to cook you dinner, all that, and how good I cook. And you told him it'll be easier for us to be together when this course stuff's over. Your mom ain't gonna be over. She don't want you to have kids back. She knows if I'm with you, I always keep my word and I will bring them home. And she knows I will. That's why she's gotta keep in your head. And she knows I'm the only man you ever loved. She knows that. She knows that you love me and I would do anything in the world for you. She making you do the things you do. And I said, I could tell in the courtroom what you want to do. You're in a dark place. Because you are not happy and it isn't where you want to be. You know you're better than anybody. Because I showed you, your mom's told your whole life you gotta spread your legs to get a man. Showed you didn't. I just got to know you. Hung out. Kicked it. Used to smoke weed, smoke a joint, laugh, talk. I just got to know Kate first. I miss that, I miss you. I promise you will. Get her out of your life. You will be much, much happier. I promise you will. She is a burden tearing you down. Kick her out of your life before she destroys you. And kills you and lives off your death. I promise you'll be so much happier. It'll be like a weight lifted you never know. Keep that worthless fucking snake bitch Casey out of your life too, because I think her and her mom are in the shit now. I'm not saying you gotta come back or you talk to me. I'm not telling you, you will be much happier. If I've been wrong, your mind will clear. You'll see things more clearly. Have I ever been wrong? Have I ever told you wrong? Have I lied to you? You know the answer to that. You used to call me and say, I just want to hear your voice. It calms me. Now all of a sudden, I'm a trigger. It's your fucking mom putting that shit in your fucking head, Kate. You know, you know what you feel for me. Same thing I feel for you. I care about you. I love you. I don't know what I'd do if something happened to you. It wouldn't be good. I know she's fucking pimping you out. Probably when you see me at Kroger's, you change like normal. Brian said every time we saw it, you saw me change. You started acting different. He said, I could tell she missed you. You always miss me. I always miss you. Quit letting her fucking make your life decisions for you, because she's going to fucking destroy you and kill you. She does not give a fuck about you, about them kids. She only cares about her worthless fucking self-centered self. Listen, I want you to do the world a favor and have a fucking die, bitch. She ain't doing your daughter none. Fucking piece of shit. I got you some more stuff if you need it. You know where I'm at. I'm not gonna tell anybody, so if you don't tell anybody, don't tell Anna, you'll be just fine. Worth a fucking cut. Don't let her get in your head either. You didn't have to go to Kroger today. You went there because you wanted to see me. Because you miss me. Because you know who you love. Like I've never felt my life inside of me. I don't know if it ever stopped. I'm not mad at you. I know you didn't want to do it. It ain't over. It's motherfucking far from over. I go out to Walmart and get some money. I don't feel like it.